What if your ESP32 could create a floating 3D hologram without any fancy equipment? This is a 3D Pikachu rendered in real time on ESP32-S3. By placing a small prism cube on top of the screen, it creates a stunning holographic illusion. It looks like a hologram, but it's not actually a hologram. Still, it's a clever optical illusion. There are several other applications for this. For instance, creating a head-up display would be great, but I feel rendering a 3D model would be more effective for my use case. I personally like them too. Right now, it's only capable of very basic rendering, but I believe with a little more development, it'll be possible to create some very interesting applications. Who knows? Here's the hardware behind the magic, an ESP32-S3 board connected to a 1.3-inch display. Compact, efficient, and perfect for portable display projects. Most manufacturers these days have a very good quality, not only hardware quality, but also the example source code they provide seem to work very well. So I was able to easily test the device through the wiki page they provided. The setup is simple. Insert the SD card with a video file. I prepared one of my favorite animations for this demo. Maybe if you are around my age, you will know. Let's see. I have this 3D printed case because I bought the case and prism cube together. As you can see, assembly is very simple. Finally, place the prism cube on top of the display and you are done. Let's connect the power and see what kind of video I put there. This is a Japanese animation called the Future GPX Cyber Formula. I remember watching it with my younger brother when I was little and having a lot of fun. I just picked this without any specific reasons. The SD card contains the files converted to MJPEG. It is still difficult to directly decode and play videos such as MP4 on ESP32 without hardware acceleration. That's why most of them are converted to formats such as MJPEG and played. Converting the video is a bit tedious, but it works well, so I'm not too disappointed. I'm looking into how to use this for productivity rather than decoration. It seems like it'd be much more fun to use this device by connecting it to Unity or Blender and viewing the objects on the screen directly in this prism, but I don't know yet. I think we need to put in more effort for that. This matrix effect library is something I made a long time ago and I tried it here. It's not that bad. If we are drawing screen using GFX graphics in Arduino environment, just give it a try. Not bad. That's it for today. Thank you for watching. See you on the next project.